Hello, assalamualaikum my lovely students. Today we are going to learn about self-introductions or perkenalan diri. Okay, but before that, you have to know about the basic concept in talking about self. There are several basic concepts that you have to know. Okay, the first is things to talk in talking about self. Introducing yourself, and the last, introducing other people. Those are the basic concepts in talking about self. Next, we move to things to talk in talking about self. Hal apa saja sih yang kita katakan saat kita ingin memperkenalkan diri? First, name atau nama. Berikutnya ada age, umur, address, alamat, profession, pekerjaan, family, keluarga, hobi, dan favorite things atau hal-hal favorit kita. Seperti your favorite food, your favorite drink, your favorite subject, and many more. Now, we move to how to introduce yourself in English. The first, you have to start your conversation by using greeting. Jadi, sebelum memperkenalkan diri, harus menggunakan salam dulu ya. Berikut adalah contohnya. Hello, everyone. Hello, everybody. Hello, semuanya. Hi, everyone. Hi, everybody. Hello, semuanya. Good morning. Selamat pagi. Good afternoon. Selamat siang atau sore. Good evening. Selamat malam. Next, kalian bisa menggunakan let me introduce myself. Perhatikan, introduce. Dibacanya introduce. Next, allow me to introduce myself. Allow. Dibacanya allow. Allow me to introduce myself. Next, I would like to introduce myself. I would. Kalau disingkat menjadi I'd like to introduce myself. I'd like to introduce myself. The next, may I introduce myself? May I introduce myself? Next, you can talking about your name. For example, my name is Jade. Or my name's Jade. You can also use another options like I am Jade or I'm Jade. You can call me Jade. Jadi titik-titiknya bisa diisi dengan data kalian ya. Or you can use my nickname is Jade. Nama panggilanku Jade. After that, you can tell about your age or umur. Kalian bisa menggunakan cara ini ya untuk menyatakan umur dalam bahasa Inggris. For example, I am blah 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 years old. Or my age is blah 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 years old. The following are the examples how to use them. I am 17 years old. Or, saya berusia 17 tahun. My age is 17 years old. Yang artinya, umur saya 17 tahun. After that, you can share about your address to them. For example, I am from blah blah blah. Saya berasal dari I come from blah blah blah. Berikut adalah contoh cara penggunaan kalimat di atas dalam bahasa Inggris. I'm from west of Sulawesi. Or you can use I come from west of Sulawesi. Untuk contoh yang lain bisa menggunakan kalimat seperti ini. I was born in blah blah blah, but currently live in blah blah blah. For example, I was born in Polewali, but currently live in Majene. Saya lahir di Polewali, tapi sekarang tinggal di Majene. Sekarang coba perhatikan contoh yang satu ini. I was born on 4th of March 2014. Coba perhatikan baik-baik. Ada perbedaan kata in dan kata on pada kalimat tersebut. Sebagai catatan, I was born in itu menanyakan tentang place of birth or POB. Jadi dia menggunakan kata in dan harus diikuti oleh keterangan tempat. Sedangkan I was born on, dia menanyakan tentang date of birth or DOB. Jawabannya adalah tanggal lahir kamu. Next, I'm originally from blah blah blah, but now I live in blah blah blah. For example, I'm originally from Polewali, but now I live in Majene. Berikutnya bisa juga dengan cara mengatakan I live in blah 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 or I live at blah blah blah. Cuman kalau menggunakan kata at harus dilengkapi dengan alamat lengkap ya. Contohnya, I live in Polewali. I live at Toilan Street number 8 Polewali Mandar. Next, share about your profession. Contohnya, kalau kalian siswa bisa menggunakan I am a student at Vocational High School of Campalagian. Saya adalah siswa di SMK Campalagian. Perhatikan peletakan kata at dan of-nya ya. Berikut adalah nama-nama jenjang pendidikan dalam bahasa Inggris. Pertama, elementary school for SD, junior high school, SMP, senior high school, SMA, Islamic boarding school, madrasah atau pesantren, dan university untuk universitas. Berikut ada beberapa contoh lagi yang menyatakan tentang profession. I am a teacher at a private school. I am a doctor at a public hospital. Next, you can share about your family members. For example, my father's name is blah blah blah. My mother's name is blah blah blah. For example, my father's name is Amran. My mother's name is Wati. My father is a or an blah blah blah. My mother is a or an blah blah blah. For example, my father is an artist. Okay, coba perhatikan kata an artist-nya. Kenapa kita pakai an? Kata an digunakan apabila dia diikuti oleh kata benda yang berhuruf vokal atau vowel. Mana itu huruf vowel? A, I, U, E, O. Sedangkan untuk kata benda yang berawalan dengan huruf konsonan, dia akan menggunakan kata a. Contohnya sebagai berikut. My mother is a housewife. Berikut hal-hal yang bisa kita share tentang family members. I have one younger brother and two elder sisters. Saya memiliki satu adik laki-laki dan dua kakak perempuan. Younger brother, elder sisters. Younger brother adalah adik laki-laki, younger sister adik perempuan, elder brother kakak laki-laki, elder sister, kakak perempuan. I'm an only child. Saya anak tunggal. I'm the eldest child. Saya anak sulung. I'm the youngest child. Saya anak bungsu. I am the first child of three siblings. Saya anak pertama dari tiga bersaudara. The first, pertama. The second, kedua. The third, ketiga, the fourth, keempat, and etc. I am the eldest child of three siblings. Saya anak sulung dari tiga bersaudara. I'm the youngest child of three siblings. Saya anak bungsu dari tiga bersaudara. Now, you can share about your hobbies. My hobby is, or my hobbies are, or you can say I like. Penggunaan kata my hobby is apabila hobinya hanya satu, sedangkan penggunaan my hobbies are apabila hobinya lebih dari satu. For example, my hobby is reading, or my hobbies are cooking and reading. Bisa juga menggunakan kata I like. For example, I like reading, I like swimming, I like cooking, and etc. Berikut adalah daftar kosakata yang bisa kamu gunakan untuk mengatakan hobi. Reading, membaca. Swimming, berenang. Singing, menyanyi. Playing guitar. Listening to music. Cooking. Hiking. Playing football. Playing game. Now you can share about your favorite subject. My favorite subject at school is or are. Seperti sebelumnya ya, kalau favorite subjectnya satu pakai is, kalau lebih dari satu pakai are. For example, my favorite subject at school is English. Kalau favorit subjeknya 2, bisa menggunakan My favorite subjects at school are English and Biology. Berikut adalah daftar kosakata tentang subjek atau mata pelajaran dalam bahasa Inggris yang bisa kamu gunakan. English, bahasa Inggris. Biology, biologi. Chemistry, kimia. Math, matematika. History, sejarah. Geography, geografi. Computer science, ilmu pengetahuan komputer. Fashion design, desain busana. Sport, olahraga. Civic education, PKN atau pendidikan kewarganegaraan. Next, you can share about your favorite food. My favorite food is blah blah blah. I like blah blah blah. For example, you can say my favorite food is fried rice. Or I like fried chicken. Berikut adalah daftar kosakata tentang makanan yang kemungkinan bisa menjadi referensi buat kalian untuk digunakan. Fried rice, nasi goreng. Fried chicken, ayam goreng. Grilled chicken, ayam bakar. Chicken soup, sop ayam. Snacks, cemilan. Fritters, gorengan. Instant noodles, mie instan. Burger, burger. Donut, donut. Okay, next, you can share about your favorite drinks. Jadi polanya sama ya, yang seperti tadi bisa pakai my favorite drink is atau I like. For example, my favorite drinks is coffee. Or I like orange juice. My favorite drinks is milk. Next, you can talk about your goals or your dream. Want to be blah blah blah. For example, I want to be an English teacher. I want to be a doctor. I want to be a scientist. I want to be a businessman. I want to be a dentist. I want to be a singer. Or I want to be a designer. Okay, now if you want to close your conversations, you can use these expressions. Jadi kalau ingin di close, kalian bisa menggunakan nice to meet you, pleased to meet you, happy to see you, I'm glad to meet you, how do you do? Berikut adalah pertanyaan-pertanyaan seputar perkenalan diri. What is your name? Siapa namamu? Where do you live? Kamu tinggal di mana? Where do you come from? Kamu berasal dari mana? Do you mind if I ask how old you are? What do you like to eat? What do you like to drink? What do you want to be? What subject do you like the most at your school? Now I'm going to give you a little example how to introduce yourself. Hello everyone, good morning. I'd like to introduce myself. My name is Dewi Jasmine. You can call me DJ. I'm originally from Majene, but currently live in Polewali. I'm 18 years old. I am a student of Vocational High School of Champalagian in the 11th grade. I'm the eldest child of 4 siblings. My father is an artist and my mother is an English teacher at a private school. Well, I love listening to music in my free time and my dream is to be a designer. Okay, that's all. Thank you everyone. Nice to meet you. Next, we are going to learn about how to introduce other people. These are some expressions that you can use to introduce other people. Let me to introduce you to blah blah blah. Or allow me to introduce you to blah blah blah. As an example, let me introduce you to Mr. Aswir. Atau kalian juga bisa menggunakan ekspresi berikut. I would like to introduce you to, kalau disingkat bisa menggunakan I'd like to introduce you to. Cara bacanya I'd like. Example, I'd like to introduce you to Mr. Amran. Okay, my lovely students, this is the sample how to introducing others. Hello everyone, good morning. I'd like to introduce you to Mr. Aswir. Well, this is a friend of mine, Mr. Aswir. He's a businessman. He lives in Champalagian. Thank you.